Well, what's up, guys? It's Thanksgiving, and you may think I'm a little crazy for doing herping when it's this cold, but really, there's actually some salamanders that I can find out here, and I was at this place yesterday. It's basically this really big spring-fed pool, and it's got a bunch of newts in it, a bunch of central newts. So I'm gonna go head up there right now. I'm walking on the trail that leads to it, and I'm actually gonna try and get some underwater footage of these newts swimming and hopefully get some really cool footage, because this isn't something I see very often. And here we are. I can already see the newts swimming around. So it's really, really cool. Basically what you get is there's a spring-fed creek going up that way. The water's just coming out of the hill and it flows down into this big old pool, and I think this is man-made, I'm not sure. But nonetheless, it fills into this big pool, and then this pool overflows, and then it spills out, and it goes down that hillside, and it just goes down the hills like that, and it's really, really cool. And you basically get this really, really, for the most part, pretty clear water, you know, to a certain depth, of course. There's a bunch of newts in there, and I'm gonna try and film them. So I've got my game plan here. I'm gonna run you through it. So I've got my snake tongs here, and I've got my net. The net is for later. I wanna actually catch one and get it out so I can get some pictures and get a closer look at it. But for now, I don't wanna remove the newts from the water because I wanna get footage of them swimming. So what I've got are my good old snake tongs here. So I've got a GoPro right here. I'm just gonna turn that bad sucker on. Bang, bang, bang. Awesome. All right. Just gonna take these suckers, just gonna grab the GoPro like that, and push it through the water and see what kind of shots I can get. So I'm gonna cut to the GoPro footage now and we'll see how this goes. Got him. Oh, there's also a tadpole in there. Well, here we are. Whoa, that is awesome. Here, let me put this tadpole back because, you know, I don't want him to not be in his water. Boop, there he goes. Oh, but look at this newt. Now, what I've got here is actually the final stage that the central newt goes through. And this newt is considered an adult. So basically, it's really interesting. They kind of go full circle. What happens is, you know, they start off as an egg, which they lay in the water. Then from there, they hatch out of that egg and they become a larval newt, which, you know, has got like fleshy gills on either side of its neck. And then from that aquatic larval stage that they go through, they then turn into something that's known as an eft. An eft is the terrestrial version of this species. So basically an eft you would see up in those forests. They stay as an eft for a good little bit, and then once they are adults, they come back to where it all began, which is, you know, this little pool right here, and they then transform into this fully aquatic adult, and that is the story of the newt, specifically in this guy's case, the central newt. But, you know, super duper cool stuff. It's just really awesome being able to come out here on a really cold day and, you know, still be able to find herps like this. Really cool stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and get some pictures and footage, and I'll let them go, but that's awesome. Oh, piggy. Piggy, piggy. That's not a pig. Here comes my piggy. Here he comes. Here he comes. Hello. Guess what I've got? Guess what I've got? Yes. Yes. There's a good piggy. Do you like it? Yes, you do. All right, so I'm out in the forest right now, And it's raining a little bit, so what I think I'm gonna go ahead and do here is flip some... Jeez Louise, I guess it's not just rain. Anyway...
There's a bunch of logs and stuff off in the forest, and you know, I think there's a few salamander species I may be able to find if I flip enough logs out there. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now, and I might actually get lucky and find a few.
Come out here, flip random logs out in the woods, and hope maybe a salamander of some kind pops up at some point. Oh, yep, that's it, that's it. That is it. There you go. That, my friends, is a zigzag salamander, exactly what I thought might be out here.
This species of salamander right here is exactly what I thought, you know, I might find out in these forests. This is a northern zigzag salamander. I'm pretty sure it's a northern, I may be wrong, but it's a zigzag salamander. And, you know, you can tell they're a zigzag salamander because of that, you know, the zigzag that goes down their back. That's how they get their name. And, you know, there's the lead phase and then there's this phase. This is the more colorful phase, you know, the one that, you know, you would understand why they would call it a zigzag salamander more. That's one of the main ways you find them is flipping up logs out in the forest like this, and rocks, of course, and you'll just get them chilling under them, and they're a cool little plethodon salamander out in the woods, so. But that's a great find. I'll go ahead and put him back, and maybe I'll find something else. Who knows?
And off he goes. Have fun.
So I think I want to try and spice things up just a little bit. So, you know, basically we're staying in this nice little house, right? And down the street about, you know, over there somewhere, there is a big rock face. And I think there's probably going to be some salamanders in it. So I think I'm going to take my flashlight, you know, shine in the cracks, see if there's any little faces, you know, looking back at me. So I think this should go pretty well. I hope, hey, buddy. Hey there, fella, how's it going? You're gonna be on YouTube. You're gonna be famous. I'm just kidding, I am far from that.
There's a big fella, there's a big fella.
Anyway, let's go find some salamanders. Oh, shit. That probably gave that little cock a heart attack.
Yeah, essentially, you walk out here to this road, and there's a rock face there, there's a rock face there, and those are the two main ones I'm gonna be looking in. Well, here we are.
See, I've got my flashlight here, and all I'm gonna do is, you know, I'm gonna find cracks like this, and I'm just gonna shine my light in them, see if there's any salamanders, and if there is, great. If there's not, I'll just keep looking.
Sweet. Uh-oh. We've got our first salamander, and as I imagined, that's a cave salamander.
I think this is about as close of a look you're gonna get, but yeah, that's a cave salamander. I think I'll probably see quite a few more of these, so I'll keep it brief with him, and I'll keep looking around, but cool. Cave salamander, great start.
I've been shining my light in the cracks, and I just fished out a species of salamander.
So what we've got right here is another zigzag salamander, but this one is actually a different phase.
This is the lead phase
zigzag salamander, and they look quite a bit different from the, you know, the zigzags that actually have a zigzag going down their back. You can see this one kind of looks like it's got like salt and pepper sprinkled all over its back. And I just found him in one of these cracks like I usually do. And cool find. I'll go ahead and let him go and put him back in the crack. Alright, little guy. That's how you find these salamanders in a lot of cases. Whoop! There he goes. Alright, let's keep shining. Well, here's a cave salamander. There he is. You can see him just a little bit there. I'm gonna try and get him out here right now. Let's give it a shot.
I got him out. This is a cave salamander. As you can see, they are absolutely gorgeous. They are a salamander to behold, for sure.
You know, it's not an uncommon sight to see them in these little rock crevices, even if there isn't a cave present, because they don't necessarily need to be around a cave despite their name being a cave salamander. You just very commonly find them in caves.
But yeah, super exciting stuff. You know, this is only one of about the four species that I've seen in this rock crevice so far. I had a long-tail salamander and a slimy salamander get away from me just a minute ago, unfortunately. Cave salamander, really nice. I'm gonna go ahead and let him go and keep going. I mean, this is going great so far. I'm really happy with how this has been going.
There you go. Yeah, and there he goes. He'll be just fine right in there.
So I'm back at the house now, and we just had a crap ton of rain. Like, I mean, the bottom fell out for almost the entire day. And, you know, I'm just walking out here in the driveway, and it's really, really cool. I've got to show you all this.
So literally just right here in the driveway, check this out. That right there is a southern two-line salamander just crawling up this little curb right here. And believe it or not, this is not the only one out here. Take a look at this. There is another one right here. He's actually crawling from underneath the garage door right here, so that's actually really neat. But yeah, another southern two-line salamander right there. It just started raining again, which is why these things are out in such force tonight. I'm gonna see if there's a few more out. Yep. Yeah, lucky number three right there. That is another southern two-line salamander literally right here in the driveway of where we're staying. How cool is that? Look at that little guy go. He's just chugging along. Well, I'm going to leave him to it.
Like, how neat is that? Literally, the house is right there. And, you know, just behind me on the driveway, you get tons of, you know, two-line salamanders just wandering around when it starts raining. So that is really cool. That is just awesome.